So let's talk about Whoopi. So we first have the video of Whoopi's initial comments. Then I got the video of her apology of after the fact. So let's listen to her comment real quick. I don't know how long. I think it's about a 2-minute video. Let's go.
To do this, then let's be truthful about it, because the Holocaust isn't about race.
No.
It's not about race.
It's about a different race.
But it's not about race. It's not about race.
What is it about?
Because it's about man's inhumanity to man. That's what it's about.
But it's about white supremacy.
But these are two white groups of people.
Well, that how was after black
people,
too.
They didn't see them as white people.
But you're missing the point. The minute you turn it into race, it goes down this alley. Let's talk about it for what it is. It's how people treat each other. It's a problem. It doesn't matter if you're black or white, because black, white, Jews, everybody eats each other. So is it, if you're uncomfortable, if you hear about mouse, should you be worried? Should your child say, oh my God,
let me ask y'all something.
I only saw the first couple seconds. I don't see the full one. Now I'm a little confused.
Please. I want to add some context for y'all.
Some context. Okay.
Okay. Now, wouldn't this be ironic if this was a black lady who named herself after Jewish people?
Her name is Goldberg.
Oh! You know that's not her real name, right?
We had talked about this stuff before. I think early on when we first started doing this. What was her name again?
Something else.
I remember we looked this up last time. Real quick, Ian, look up Whoopi Goldberg's real last name. I remember doing this last time we talked. We mentioned her name.
I ain't trying to be divisive, but all my Jewish people, y'all need to tell her to take that Berg off her name ASAP. ASAP. We want it off. Karen. We want it off.
Johnson.
I'm just playing. That shit was hilarious when she said it, though. I apologize. That shit was hilarious because she was waiting for her dramatic pauses for the claps to come, and they didn't go, so she had to keep digging deeper. Because y'all missed the point. You know what I'm saying? If she makes it, basically what happened, she said some real dumb shit, and then she tried to make the conversation bigger than the original point, so that way
I wish I was able to find the fuller clip. Like, what was the topic of discussion? Because I'm assuming they present topics, and then they share their opinion, similar to what kind of we're doing.
Dude, this is what they always talk about on The View. 25 years of Holocaust.
Nah, but she just tried to make it seem like she was talking about, humanity in general. So, like, if we're talking about, the way man treats man, you can apply that to anything.
Yeah, but exactly. All her comments were so generic that, like,
exactly.
What point are you trying to make here? Because
she wanted to seem smart. In my opinion, she wanted to seem smart. She wanted to seem deep. Who am I? I don't know.
I like that one lady that's just like, well, in the middle of, like, her statement when she's waiting for, like, the applause. Because there's two of them that are like, yeah. Is that one? Well, I don't know about that.
Well, their initial reaction was to agree with her. Because you said when she says, I forgot what she says, and they all repeat it. Then they process. It sits finally in their head what she actually said. And they're like, wait, hold on.
That's why I cracked up, because of that one woman who said that.
Oh, what we just seen, that was a lie, Ethan. Huh. Last name's not Goldberg.
We'll go back to it real quick, Ian, if you didn't click off it. If you did, then don't worry about it. Let's go to her apology. So in their apology, I skimmed through this really quickly just to get the context. So I have the first, like, half her apology. It starts at 114, if you got it ready. And it's, I just don't like Colbert's, I guess, the back and forth between them too, because they just kind of feed into each other. For me, it's kind of annoying. But the entire thing is from the 114 to 642. So we'll watch the first half of the conversation, then we'll see if you guys want to see more of it. Go ahead, Ian. Oh yeah, it's on the 2. Yeah, I had to. Like I said, I skimmed through this real quick.
Like, damn, we're gonna go quick.
I like how all of Whoopi Goldberg's clothes are like shawls.
He looks like a professor everywhere she goes, man.
A professor of magic.
Yeah, like a Hogwarts teacher. Yeah.
Yo, play. Actually, time out.
Black
top
Harry
hat.
Potter.
Black Harry Potter.
Look at the glasses.
Look for the scar.
Harry Potter.
No, but real quick, Doc, If she put on a top hat, does she look like that one assassin character on Cowboy Bebop?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she kind of would.
She sees the top hat and the cane.
Calm down. I'm not going to let y'all talk about anybody from the Jewish community this way. Come on.
Going to play.
I don't know, because it confused some people.
It upset a lot of people, yes. Which was never, ever, ever, ever my intention. I thought we were having a discussion. Because I feel
what was it?
Being black, when we talk about race, it's a very different thing to me. Mm-hmm. So I said that I felt that the Holocaust
what does that mean?
About race. And people got very, very, very angry and still are angry. I mean, I'm getting, you know, all of the mail from folks and mm-hmm. the very real anger because people feel very differently. But I thought it
pause or kicking in. I'm sorry, that's bothering me. I can't help but let that go. I'm actually curious, what does that mean?
What does what mean?
Because I'm black, I have a different what was it she said? Meaning or something of race?
Run it back.
I'm kind of combining that statement with something she said during the View video that we're watching, because one thing she says is that
right there, you're good.
It's different because it was white people interacting with other white people. And then some of the ladies push back like, what? That's still like, just because they're white doesn't mean they're not different races.
Yeah, facts.
And so I think that's why when she's saying this, she's drawing the line in the sand even harder, that skin tone is literally the line between races, as opposed to having the same skin tone, but then they're being varying races within that one skin tone. So she's not really grasping that, if that makes any sense.
But she says all this while her last name is Goldberg. That is wild that she
has Ethan's trying to prove, like, no, her name is Goldberg. I mean,
No. Well, hey, Ethan, she said, Goldberg is my name.
And if Goldberg is her name, then...
She didn't say that was the name she was born with. She didn't say that was her mother's maiden name. She didn't say any of those things. She said, Goldberg is my name. Goldberg... Never mind. I won't make any wrestling jokes.
Sticking that the whole time you said Goldberg is my name. I was just cracking. I was thinking of him.
But nah, I think she was trying to finesse with the words. But go for it, play.
Yeah, play real quick. Because I'm actually...
Because I feel, being black, when we talk about race, it's a very different thing to me.
Pause.
Mm-hmm. So
what is she trying to say there?
But she said, I feel, being black, group, when we talk about race, it's a different thing to me, singular, again.
Okay.
So, honestly, just a bunch of nothing. She just used the group, but she didn't really talk about why that, her association with that group made the difference. You know what I'm saying? She just said it. You want to know why, but she just said it. Like, there's no why. She just said it. Like, that's what she's...
I think she's drawing the line between skin tones, man. She's saying just black and white, that's the line. And white on white violence doesn't have to fall into race.
Yeah, I think she eventually gets into that. Pleiadians, let's finish this out.
Said that I felt that
that just doesn't make sense to me, I'm sorry. Or not make sense, it's just... Like you said, it doesn't mean anything. Doesn't so what do you think? So what do you think it means? And she kind of...
I think it's a cop-out. I think it's
her I get saying. What you're saying.
She's just associating herself with, I'm black. You know, black people plight or whatever, I just associate it differently. It's kind of like using it as even though it's not a protected class, people feel somehow, you know, black people, it's hard to be critical of them or whatever. It's not the case, but sometimes people use it as cop-outs because on TV, you can't attack her blackness or you'll look like the bad guy or anything like that. So, to be honest with you, just
and even still, that would look weak. That's like, why would you attack someone's...
No, exactly. No, but I'm saying it's word association.
Okay. Go ahead, Ian.
And people got very, very, very angry and still are angry. I mean, I'm getting, you know, all of the mail from folks and mm-hmm. the very real anger because people feel very differently. But I thought it was a salient discussion because as a black person, I think of race as being something that I can see. So
pause.
I see you.
What does that mean? Is race something I can see? Is it specifically like
said, black and white?
Okay. Yeah, she's drawing the line between colors.
Mm-hmm.
It's a simple look at race, but okay, go on.
Mm-hmm. Know what race you are. And the discussion was about how I felt about that. I felt that it was really more about man's inhumanity to man and how horrible people are.
Isn't racism also an example of man's inhumanity against man?
She was using a general statement. So, like, what she's saying is you can't technically say she was wrong because she's saying it was man's inhumanity to man. But you can apply that to anything. Why was the man inhumane to the other men? Because of their race.
But people are, because I read the comments, that's why I have questions, because I was actually more shocked to see a good, out of the 20, I scrolled down real quick, I would say roughly half said she's not wrong though and supported her, in other words, obviously like this.
Because they're sticking to the point. It's like,
but there's,
I'm not,
but
talking
not a
about
real
all
point
this
there.
Other,
that's
no,
why I'm
I'm
so
not talking about all this other stuff.
Okay.
I'm talking about this being man's, and it is man's inhumanity or whatever the fuck she's saying to man. But it's like you asking me a question that's more specific than that, and I keep reciting that same answer. That's what they're doing. They're not acknowledging that she's wrong in the context of what she was saying. They're just acknowledging that sentence alone when it stands by itself.
That was only my point, and because that's my point, it doesn't matter what I said prior.
But it's a cop-out because it's bullshit. It's complete bullshit. She basically tripped over her words, and now we know you see race as black and white. If all white people are just all white people, and then if all people of fair skin or whatever is just all people of fair skin, all people of darker skin are just all people of darker skin. That's how she views it. But like, there's racism between, you know what I'm saying? So
the reason why I'm trying to ask these questions after she makes this point is because one thing that was I thought was interesting, which I'm going to defend Whoopi to a degree here, is the interaction, the view. This all could have been squashed. This I don't think would have progressed if the viewer actually genuine to each other when it comes to these conversations.
No. They throw each other under the bus. I wonder how many apologies the view has actually issued. Like,
which
how
is
many
weird.
Different.
That's why I don't understand why people watch them. Like, because the conversation wasn't genuine. If, for example, God forbid, I ever said something along the lines of what Whoopi said, y'all will obviously be friends and just give me the face. Like, did you really just say what you just said? Like, kind of like their reaction. Kind of, but I feel like obviously more funny. Like, I know you guys. Mm-hmm. I know your reaction when I say something dumb. Mm-hmm. I say with Doc. I know exactly how he'd react. Like, really? And then John.
Well, it kind of depends, man, because the other women on the show actually do react to her like that after they process what she just said. Mm-hmm. And, like, there's a chance that her ego is just big enough that she didn't accept it.
Boom.
But my thing is, maybe this is my bias then, or my inappropriate assumption of y'all, but y'all would be more aggressive about it. Like, you're just not going to let, for example, back to my example, me slide and not accept what I just said was either wrong or short-sighted.
Because the second you try and do what she did, the tactic, where she just basically put in that bar.
You wouldn't allow me.
I'm going to let you have the bar, and then I'm going to attack everything else. Okay, that is a fact. But now I need you to apply it to this situation. No, not even that. Explain to me why it wasn't racism. Just do that. Now you in a bundle. You in a corner
because
on the
argument
tight ropes.
Is that the question now is Judaism, Jewish people, a
okay,
race?
What is race? Can you look up the definition of race, please?
Why is doing that? And that's why I guess I have issue with the view, because it's not genuine people sitting down to have genuine conversation. You're just trying to position yourself.
Yeah.
That's why it's weird, as you just said, they throw each other under the bus all the time. That's weird. You mean I can't sit down with y'all and actually have a vulnerable conversation about some crazy things going on in the world? I think that's weird.
I don't want to say what came to my mind.
Do you got the definition up, Ian? All right, this podcast is sponsored by Angel Blinds. Shout out Angel Blinds. It's a local business based in Atlanta, Georgia. Check them out. Their blinds help you get a new look for your living room, to your bedroom, to your dining room. They even customize kids' blinds with their favorite superhero or princess. Make sure you get Iron Man. He's the best. Shout out. With our promo code FDT, our audience gets 10% off their first purchase. You can find them on Facebook at Angels Blinds or their Instagram at Angels_Blinds. Shout out Angels Blinds. Okay, there you go. Race
is
defined.
What you do when the police looking for you. and you don't want to be cut.
Race is defined as a category of humankind that shares certain distinctive physical traits. The term ethnicities is more broadly defined as large groups of people classed according to common racial, national, tribal, religious, linguistic, or cultural origin or background.
So would Jewish people be considered a race?
I think the Nazis did consider it a race because they practiced eugenics to try to find Jews.
Yeah,
because
they want, didn't they want like blonde hair and blue eyes or something like that? Like that was their thing. Yeah,
they wanted the Aryans.
On them.
And they developed a pseudoscience to try to pinpoint who were Jews and who were descendants of Jews.
Were they able to?
I'm sure to a degree they were.
Yeah, I'm sure they were. To sure the effectiveness of
so that question. Being the distinguishing trait amongst those people, would that classify them as, like, would that be described as Jewish? You get what I'm saying?
Well,
for example, if all black people have something in common, but other than skin.
We don't have to go that deep.
You get what I'm saying?
Because if you see somebody and what's something, a common trait you could say Jews have?
Black is what?
Black, what do you mean? Are you talking about the color or?
Is a race or is ethnicity?
I don't know. I don't think black is either. I don't think black is race or ethnicity. I think it's just literally just a color.
What's my race?
What's your race? Well, Nigerian. No? Or is that your ethnicity?
I'm confused again. I learned this shit as a kid now.
Would they say black is your race? But
I don't know.
Go back to the definition real quick. No, I'm genuinely confused now. I feel.
What are we?
I feel dumb.
Me too.
So, any one of the groups that humans are often divided into based on physical traits or regard as common among people of the shared ancestry. Okay, shared traits. So I guess
I see Anglo-Saxon.
So are short people a race then? We should all share a trait.
That's what I'm confused about now. What is a race?
A group with a species that is distinguishable as morphologically, genetically, or behaviorally from others of the same species.
Okay, so I saw something that said there are six races. What are the six races?
I guess just
that would help.
Just go to Google, then use quotation marks, six races. Okay, you can do that too.
White, American Indian, Alaska Native, Asian, Black, or African American. Huh?
Huh?
Is that the government form? What the fuck?
What are?
But it's not official. On the very end, but it's not official. So this is just
talking. Just talking. Just rubbish.
Okay, white, OBE black requires it. Yeah, white, black, or African. Yeah, again, like what?
They're being politically.
This
correct.
Is the race U.S. Census Bureau. So this is So this is for the U.S. specifically.
So black is a race. White is a race.
I don't agree with that.
Yeah, I don't know. I was about to say that's convenient. Wild. That seems convenient.
Because then she could say, technically speaking.
Fuck, is Whoopi right?
Technically, they're not a race, so I wasn't wrong.
Well, quick question. The continent of Asia. Would Russians be considered Asian? I don't say they don't share a feature, but I thought that was...
Russia still in Europe?
If we're getting fucking technical, then Mongolia is the end of, like, Asia, and then
Russia's
Europe. Russia's in Europe.
But it's...
It's Russia's Europe. I know.
But they don't share features, but they share a continent called Asian. I thought that's the reason why we called Asians Asian.
No, Chinese people and Indian people are both Asians. But Russians are Europeans.
Yeah, because of...
This is going to show you how stupid this all is.
So it really is. So, hey, look. So if her lawyer was defending her, right, he will come to the courtroom and he'd say, Your Honor, Jewish people is not a race.
So we've been roasting her for a minute now. So real quick, I would say, there's forgiveness. But my problem is the way she's going about, one, asking for it, and two, it seems like she doesn't realize exactly what she said is wrong.
Shit yet.
All right, let's finish the last...
When we're seeing it manifest itself these days, but people were very angry and they said, no, we are a race. And I understand. I felt differently. I respect everything everyone is saying to me. And I don't want to fake apologize. I'm very upset about that people are misunderstood what I was saying. And so because of it, they're saying that I'm anti-Semitic and that I'm denying the Holocaust.
I wouldn't say she's anti-Semitic.
Well, hold on.
Yeah, I wouldn't agree with that either.
They're saying, yeah, to your guy's point, they're saying anti-Semitic instead of racist. But we're talking about race, right? Dude, this shit, I ain't gonna lie.
Anti-Semitic is a specific version of racism. Anti-Semitic literally means, I think, racism against Jewish people. It's a special word they use. They don't just say racism. If you're being racist against Jew, it's anti-Semitic.
But they wouldn't say racism towards Jewish people. They would use another word. It'd be, it'd be something, but the action wouldn't be racism. Like, for example, when you define racism, what is the action in racism that's being done towards the other race? I don't know why my mind's having a brain fart right now, but
you just hate something about them.
You're being hateful or whatever. It would be hate towards the Jews, but it wouldn't be seen at the word race wouldn't be in there. I'm trying to learn today that Jewish. So is Nigerian is an ethnicity?
I would say it is.
Here's the monkey wrench, though. I think. I mean, I don't know if I'm right about this 100%, but
hatred towards Jewish people. But
Jewish people, they want to identify as both a race and a religion, though. They want to combine the concept of race and religion into one thing.
Hence Israel, right? Yeah.
Yeah, and like that's why like Zionism exists and stuff like that, where it's just like, no, they want to define themselves by religion and race. All in one.
I want to go. Okay, I want to go deep, okay, guys. Here,
you,
real quick.
I get you, Doc. It doesn't matter if that's what they want to be. If that's what they relate as, I get what you're saying, Doc. Okay.
So because of Israel, that they're Jewish, right? So that makes it a race because of Israel, and I'm pretty sure they share some common traits.
Wait. So is American a race?
Based off that logic, yeah.
You see, we just keep ending it. We just drive around the cul-de-sac, my boy.
But my point is, though, that because as Israel, that I would argue establishes some kind of shared traits. I've never been to Israel, so I don't know if they all look alike. They have some shared traits. I generally don't know, but I'm just trying to make a fake point here. So if there are people who have mixed children from Israel, just like we have light skin, can you be racist towards them? Or because they're not fully Jewish, they're no longer a race.
Is that a race?
Like, being mixed a race. Like,
that's where it gets really complex, because I mean, like, I'm Latin and I'm, you know, light skinned, but I have Latin features, like really dark jet straight hair, but there are also really dark Afro-Latin people, and they're still technically, like, you know, shades of color within all of that. And like Latin America and Mexico racist. Specifically is like it's one of the most mixed racist places ever. So, but even then, like, I come here, white people still, you know, they're like, oh, he's freaking, you know, he's Mexican or he's Latin or he's from a different place. And at that point, it's just like, dude, if you ever go over there, it's even more complex than what you're seeing.
Yeah.
And I think it's the same thing with Israel and like Judaism, because Jews come in all shapes and colors and they still identify themselves as Jewish, and they still, you know, when people are being mean towards specifically Jews, like, they still identify it as racism. So I think it gets kind of messy. There's no clear line of like, that's a Jew and that's, you know, a Latin person and stuff like that. There's just too many variables.
Okay, so is there a difference between a Jew and a person who describes himself as Jew and a person who describes himself as a Hebrew?
I don't think so.
Is there a distinction?
I think.
You get what I'm saying?
I think the language might be the core issue there.
Mm.
Okay. Like how people can say they're Arabic because they speak Arabic.
Yeah, because I'm going to be real about this. When I meet somebody who's Latin that doesn't speak Spanish, I have a different opinion of them. So,
hey, my guy.
to me, it's
how do you really feel about me, Doc? Let me know. Because I'm half Mexican and I can't speak Spanish. So you look down on me, Doc? Don't lie. Every time I mention you, you're like, come on, man, you gotta fucking learn Spanish. You always let me know whenever the opportunity arises. He's like, come on, man. Doc does that all the fucking time.
It's like buying a Mac and then booting it up and seeing the Windows logo and being like,
oh, hey, my God. That's deep. You know what you just said? That's deep. Jesus.
That hurts me. I'm not gonna lie. It does.
Wallahi.
So that's why I feel like you got to learn the language, man. It's the processing code. It's the binding, you know, it's the processing power, the operating system. That's what the words I'm looking
true.
For.
True. That's
I
very
think Ethan,
true.
I think Ethan just said actually differentiate the Hebrews and the Jewish people. I think Hebrews probably more aligned religious. With like the biblical following, how you live your life to the T biblically, and Jewish people who just like we do or live our life to the Bible, but like some of us are, do
our bloodline.
Have, yeah.
Okay.
Not to do our own thing, but just like we're not that strict. It's like different Christian religions. I
just
would
think
argue.
It's wild. Her name Goldberg.
How there's Baptists and Methodists. Like it's different ways of, I guess, following Jesus. Like I'm sure amongst the Judaism religion, I'm sure there's something similar. I mm-hmm. could be wrong. I could be something like a complete dumbass.
I mean, I'm pretty sure I've sounded like a dumbass for at least 39 minutes of this podcast.
Yeah, we did talk about we'll Whoopi, probably Whoopi for too been. Long.
Yeah, man. She finna cast a spell.
I was just trying to like, yeah, poor Whoopi.
Dumbledore.
Let's see.
Dumbledore.
Yo, Whoopi sounds like a Hogwarts like teacher though.
It kind of does. I'm not gonna lie.
Whoopi? Headmaster Whoopi.
Professor Whoopi. Headmaster. Whoopi? Nah, not headmaster. It'd be Professor Whoopi.
But let me just tell you something. If you see the name Whoopi Goldberg, right, and she was never an actor or an actress or whatever you want to call her,
would you think she was Jewish?
No, but yeah, before she walked in, is this what you would expect?
No.
The Whoopi name would have threw me off guard, but the Goldberg, yeah, like, okay, then she's got to be somewhere along here. Hard. Like, along this look is what I'm expecting.
As soon as I see her, God forgive me, I'm like, yo, they let you in? Hey, next topic.
Yo, thanks for making it to the end. We really appreciate it, and hope you all enjoyed the show.
Make sure you hit that subscribe button, that like button, and the notification bell to get notified when we post our clips.
Follow us on Twitter at PodcastFDT. Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok are all Fake Deep Thinking. Check us out.
FDT. Peace, y'all.
Peace.